We're none of
Yeah.
us have RRR, yeah? I know,
No,
by the
I
way.
was I was planning to put it though. I mean, I was planning to put it, but then I was like, it's fine.
I think it's
Everyone
got
already knows
enough
about it.
attention already, I feel. So,
Yeah. I mean, I don't think so. It would have made any difference, irrespective,
yeah.
I feel.
No, no, I would have loved
Okay.
to hear Mahidhar on it because I know he really dislikes it.
We will have to discuss it anyway. So we
Okay,
will.
yeah, fair enough. Yeah, it'll
Wow.
come in. Yeah.
Wow. Okay. Okay.
Yes.
Hello, hello, hello. Welcome back to Queen is Dead. I am Sanjeet. I have Dhruv with me. And today we have two very special guests with us. One is Devi and one is Maheedhar. Both of them have appeared previously on our podcast. Maheedhar more so. I mean, both of them have appeared on like two
Yeah.
episodes, I think.
Yeah.
Maheedhar in the lost episode,
Is a
is
staple
still
of Queen
lying.
is Dead, right? The
Yeah.
lost
Like,
episode.
lost
Like,
episode list. Yeah. So today we discuss the best of Indian films from basically all
Favorites.
languages. Favorites. I mean, yeah, whatever.
Yes.
And basically covers most of our lists and mostly from, I guess, southern languages at the end of the day,
I think
from
so.
whatever I know. Yeah.
Yeah.
We have like a lot of common, so we'll all chime in with whatever. And I think if we've seen, we'll put in our thoughts about the film,
Yeah.
particularly. Let's begin. Maheedhar, do you wanna start with your list?
Yeah, sure. So I have my 2022 was like not a very memorable year for my films, but
Why?
yeah.
I don't know. I just I don't remember a lot of Indian movies 2022 wise, but
Okay.
I will read out my list. So these are my top five. They are not ranked or numbered anyway. So they are just in random order. These are my top five. Vikram, obviously.
Yes. I mean,
Bheeshma
obviously, like you can. Okay, fine. I was about to
Parvam.
say, I'm not that big a fan of Vikram,
That's fine. That's fine.
but
Like
okay. Yeah,
I think we
okay.
have heard everything about Vikram, that is to say,
Yeah.
negative or positive. I've heard everything, so I don't think there's anything else to hear. But Vikram, Bheeshma Parvam,
Yeah.
Nanpakal, Nerathu, Mayakkam, which is 2022 for me at least.
For you, yeah.
Yeah. What else did I say? PS1, Pottiyin Selvan 1, and Monica, My Darling.
Yes,
Okay.
you missed
And
Thallumalla,
we
I
have,
think.
and I missed Tolly. Yeah, I was gonna say,
Yes.
and Thallumalla. Those are my top
Okay.
five.
And
I mean, I
sorry.
will tell you something. I will tell you one thing about Vikram. I understand why people don't like it. But my defense for Vikram is something I'm gonna say similar to something with Vikram Vedha, the original one, where people who watched the original Vikram Vedha, I think they had a lot of hype. Even though I think Vikram Vedha isn't that great of a movie, it's just that when you watch it in that specific time, like this time, like I know it's a broad comparison, it's too much, but like you take like Satya, right? Like people who there's always, I think people always say there's a pre-Satya and post-Satya in Bollywood, right? I think the same sense is always going to be a pre-Vikram and post-Vikram. I think that the impact of the movie
Got
is
it.
that huge
Immense.
in the industry, yeah.
But do you
I
think,
didn't get
sorry, go ahead.
the
Go ahead.
reference. Oh, sorry.
No, no, go ahead, please.
No, I didn't get the Vikram Vedha reference. I
So,
think.
no, what I'm saying is, like, when Vikram Vedha came out, it was insanely huge. Like, everybody was behind Vikram Vedha because, like, I didn't watch it in 2017 because of, I don't know why, I just never watched it.
I
And
watched it in cinema.
So when you watch it in that, like, period where everybody's hyping this specific film to watch, okay, this film is, like, when everybody's saying, okay, this film is great, you should go watch it. Like when everybody's going to the theater to watch it. I think in that sense, I'm comparing it to Vikram, where everybody was going to the theaters to watch Vikram. I
Yeah,
know
that's true.
I know very few people who haven't watched the film, right? And I know, and not only just South Indians, I'm saying North Indians as well. Everybody, like most everybody I know has watched Vikram. So I'm saying impact-wise, I'm comparing it to Vikram Vedha, where I know everybody has seen Vikram Vedha because that impact of that movie was like in another level. Especially when it got dubbed and it got sent off to like very people discovered it dubbed as well.
Got it.
Yeah.
Yeah, no, I was about to
Yeah,
ask
that
that.
was actually. Oh, sorry, I'm
No,
interrupting.
it's okay, Devi. We have that's this is our Fleabag continuation in that sense, but go ahead.
Yeah.
No, I was telling that was actually cited. What he said is, as it has been dubbed afterwards. So that was cited as one of the main reasons why Vikram Veda, after they made it, remade it in Hindi, it didn't
work.
Collect as much.
Yeah.
It is already available. The dubbed version is already available on YouTube. Yeah.
But also the remake was also like very stupidly financed.
Yeah.
No, I haven't seen it, but I know the budget of the film is like very idiotic.
Yeah, it's 100 crores, right? It was
175 crores is the reported budget, but like, I know, right? That's like, I mean,
175 crores.
Yeah.
In that 150 crores of Hrithik Roshan. In that 150 crores of Hrithik Roshan.
This is the Akshay Kumar phenomena, right? Basically. Yeah, where it's all the budgets are so inflated that there's no way these movies
you remember I told you, right? That Kathputli film, Bandhan. The budget was Rakshabandhan was 115 crore.
For what?
Like, that's like...
What Akshay Kumar.
Yeah, Akshay Kumar takes half the...
There's an old TVF video. They're parodying like a Bollywood film.
Bhai Ho.
Yeah. And in that they're saying miscellaneous expenses. And on the VPT, it's just drinks. It's just alcohol.
Have you watched the original for Kathputli? I know it's not...
Sanjeet, you watched it, right?
Yeah.
I haven't watched Rajasthan. The same thing. Like,
I've seen it.
The same thing. Everybody was watching Rajasthan. I haven't seen Rajasthan for some
reason.
Same. I have not seen it, but okay. Nini, I was about
no,
to
but
say.
You, it's fine.
Oh, wow.
Watch anyway.
That's so rude. Okay. I was about to ask, do you think it's a good thing? The impact of Vikram, like what it has done, sort of, you know, you said pre and post Vikram, right? So I think
there is a caveat. There is going to be an influx of the same type of action films that are going to come, right? Because post Satya, like, I think Satya, like, rejuvenated the gangster genre in India.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Before that, I think the film that did it was Nayagan. But after that, I think literally everybody would make gangster films, right? Even KGF's director was like, yeah, I watched RGV. That's why inspiration.
Yes.
So I think there's definitely going to be some future filmmaker that's going to be like, yeah, Vikram. Yeah, I understand why you're laughing. but still, like, the impact was that huge, right? So
Yeah.
I think it's the same in Vikram, where I think the impact is, like, it's not something that I can say. Like, if you see the impact of the film, just how people are talking about it, I think that itself is enough to tell you, okay, this film is not the same, right? Because every film hits 100 crores. Like, it's not a new thing. Like, nowadays, films getting 100 crores is not as big of a deal. But it's more than that. Like, this one, it's a cultural reset. I think for Tamil films, it's a cultural reset. In a good way, as we are now, that I think a lot of directors will actually get a little bit of creative freedom after. I think they will, because the South has a lot of this, where, except Malayalam films, I think, it's that for some reason producers don't trust directors, no matter how experienced they are. So I think with Vikram, after it, I think some producers will be like, okay, you can take creative control of the project and give a good result. I think that's one good thing. The bad thing is everybody's going to expect every next film to be like Vikram.
I mean, but everything, right? Yeah.
I was about to say, this is in your list also, so we can sort of lavish praise on it also.
I loved it too. I mean, because it's a given. But more than that, what really enticed me was the muscular filmmaking. Like, you could feel every shot, every, you know, action that takes place in the film. Which for me was like a very big plus point, because you see a lot of action films, but how do you like differentiate between them? And for me, basically was the whole fact that it's a lot of like, how much do you hold back while making a film, right? And I feel they didn't hold themselves back, and the indulgence was on all the right things, which for me is like a very big plus. Apart from that, I think there's like a lot of intricacies that we can't go into also, because there's like a lot to talk about in depth about the film. not just like how the film progresses and or how the film is charted out in a way. Like just the screenplay wise, it becomes like it changes paths, it changes like characters, it changes modes, it changes its tone. Not so much the tone, but the vibe is still the same. But like the gear shifting works really well, and like the pacing and everything is just just pitch perfect. So yeah, it's one of my favorites. I mean, I know you didn't like it so much. So I mean, you have your
I see, my thing was basically to me, like, again, I watched it much more. I watched it at home. I didn't watch it in the cinema. So your whole argument of cinema home viewing maybe applies.
Yeah, for sure.
I said maybe. But okay.
No, I'm saying
but I don't know. I remember because I had watched Kaithi just before that because I hadn't seen it before. And I really enjoyed that. But Vikram, I thought, was a lot of the which has been happening recently, which happened. I mean, I think Vikram is a much better film than Pathaan, but there's a similar, I thought, sense of universe building, which maybe I have tired of. So I was like,
By the way, Vikram has got out the universe, has popularized cinematic universe in India, which is the the worst thing. That's the worst thing.
That's what I was pointing out as the sort of is how the post effect is, how if is that going to be like the big thing about universe building and like Marvel, Marvelification almost.
I was thinking, but we can always choose to not watch those things. I mean, there's no compulsion. I mean,
no one will know, but as you said, that the directors will get more control, and Vikram is clearly a much more, I think, well directed film compared to
because a lot of Kamal Haasan, like the involvement of Kamal Haasan, basically drove the film into director's hands, also. I mean, that's the big difference, right? Because he's a producer on it, and I mean, I've seen like a lot of interviews where like he's just telling like how he gave Lokesh what he wanted and like stuff like that. And
I think it's like the perfect coming together, right? Like
It was meant to be.
A sweet spot, right? It came at the right time. The collaborations just gelled out. I mean, like you won't get another film like that, right?
It's a once in a while.
That's why I said it's a Satya, right? Because everybody, everybody unanimously agrees that Satya is like one of the best gangster films in India.
I think the impact is of course like more visible, but I think the legacy will mostly be solidified in posterity, because right now we haven't even been through a year. So maybe like 5-6 years down the line is where we'll start accepting. Like, I think the majority will start accepting the cult of the film when they'll see like a lot of failures and stuff like that, I feel.
Yeah, definitely. We're going to get a lot of copycats. That's the one thing. There's going to be a lot of copycats who are going to do the exact same thing. Like copying, you know, especially the nighttime part. I think that is something that everybody's going to use later on.
If you take like any big success, that is somewhere that kind of following that trend cashing in on that, that is inevitable.
Yeah.
You will get a lot of such copy, copycats and bad photo stats of all these.
We already have in Bollywood this year. We got.
But I wanted to tell something like with what Dhruv said about how how you are creating a universe like Marvel. But this is one universe I'm happy to watch because how Lokesh, because it is in the hands of someone like Lokesh. So I have, as Maheedhar said, it's such a beautiful collaboration with Kamal Haasan and Lokesh, like a fanboy kind of a thing. And this is a beautiful tribute. Vikram is actually a beautiful tribute.
But the context to Vikram is also very important, because before Vikram, Kamal only had Vishwarupam, which came out in
2018.
And Vishwarupam 2 didn't do well.
Yeah, 2018.
So he was doing his political career, which was also failing. And Vishwarupam 1 as well, which was like very Vishwarupam 1 and Uttama Villan, which were his like last two films that I think were moderately successful.
Mm-hmm. Even Uttam Villain didn't do very well.
But Uttam Villain was a very good movie.
I love Uttam Villain. I want to have a discussion about Uttam Villain with someone because that's the most meta, like amazing. All his movies are failing. His political career was failing. He lost the elections, I think. So it was a bad time for Kamal. Like the last 5-6 years in general were a bad time for Kamal. Even though Vishwarupam was a very big movie, it was still there was controversies around it, and even when it came out, it was banned in Tamil Nadu for like a week. So there's a lot of things. So that's what makes Vikram more special. I think it's like a very good redemption story for somebody, for like somebody like Kamal,
who deserves it.
Yeah, because Kamal has always been somebody who's been dedicated to films.
Just going off your list only, we'll also cover a couple because Sanjeet has a lot of commonalities. The other one is Bheeshma Parvam, right?
Yes.
Discuss, guys. I have not seen it.
Yeah, I'm the biggest Amal Nerathu fan, I think. So Bheeshma Parvam was a... I was happy. I got to watch Bheeshma Parvam. I watched it in the theater first day.
Mm-hmm.
So that was the best experience. And... I don't have a lot to say about Bheeshma Parvam because it's one of those movies when I don't know what you can say about it it's basically like so if you have to explain the film, it's about this family in the 80s here in Kerala.
Mm-hmm.
And I don't remember the family's name, but the head of the family is Michael.
Yeah.
Played by Mammootty, and he has his nephews one of them who wants to take over. It's basically a gangster drama.
Godfather.
I was about to say sounds very Godfather.
It is Godfather.
There's no subtlety. By the way, Amal Nerathu thanked Francis Ford Coppola. There is no subtlety about it being Godfather.
That's fine. Like, it's a template, right? Like you can do whatever you
want. So what Amalia does with that Godfather template is just takes it and revs it up to like 100.
Okay.
And again, I can't explain about Amal Nerathu movie. Like it's very difficult to break down Amal Nerathu movies because I've seen
two of them, and I know like about like the funny bits about Sagar Ilias Jackie.
Yes, my Sagar Ilias Jackie opinion is controversial with Malayali, so...
Okay.
Yeah.
Sagar Ilias Jackie Reloaded.
Yes. Whenever I say I like the movie, people don't like it. They always say watch the original. But I'm like, listen, I like Sagar Ilias Jackie. I don't know what to tell you. But yeah, I don't know how to describe Bishwara. I mean, Sanjeet, help.
Yeah. I mean, even I enjoyed it quite a lot. I mean, it was more like, how do I say... So I had seen a lot of Mammootty movies before this, not like a lot, but like a few of them. Like I had seen Piranbu and Vidayan and some of his other stuff. And this is one movie where I became like his fan in a way. Like I really wanted to watch more and more. Like you get it right when you watch like a particular actor or star or whatever, or even a director, you become a fan, right? This is that movie for me.
This is also, this is like a fanboy. I think this is also the Mammootty fanboy, fantasy. Because even Dulkar Salman was saying, I loved seeing the same thing, like seeing the 80s Mammootty on the screen. I absolutely loved it. I have nothing else to say that. If you haven't watched it, go watch it. It's a blast.
Amazon pe hai?
No,
it's on Hotstar.
Sanjeet, send me, please. You know where.
Yeah, I'll send you only Hotstar links, only legal things. Yeah.
Send me the Hotstar link, Sanjeet. I'll try and make it work in the US, yes.
Actually, all these Amal Neerad films, if you see, it's, I think, what attracts a person most to it is probably the cinematography.
It's very stylistic. It's very stylistic.
Very stylistic, yes.
Yeah. And, even Varadhan was very much that way for me. Even though I'm not one of its biggest fans or even like it, but I think Bheeshma Parvam was...
Have you seen Pustakam?
Yes, I've seen Yobinde Pustakam and Varadhan. Those are the only two ones I've seen. Yeah. But for me, this was like, how do I say, like, if you portray a star, you portray him like in that best possible way with not just like it was showy, but it was like fun. I mean, you can continue. Sorry.
Like exactly how Lokesh did with Kamal.
I was about to say, yeah, exactly. It sounds very much like that. Yes. Like a good. Anyway, so should we move on?
For me. Yeah. Go for it.
Yeah. By the way, before we move on, I would say on Bheeshma Parvam, this year was the Mammootty year because he had
all successes, no?
Yeah, all five films were a big hit.
CBI 5
was not...
but it was a box office success.
Personally, I didn't like it much.
I haven't seen CBI 5, but I have heard enough about it. So, Bheeshma Parvam, CBI 5, Puru,
Nanpakal.
Nanpakal and Rorschach.
Rorschach.
Which I think we should move on to Nanpakal because
Yes. Go ahead. All of us have seen, right?
Yeah, we have. Devi, you've seen it, right?
Devi, you've seen it.
Yeah, I've seen it in the theater.
I absolutely love it. Maheedhar, but you can start. Go ahead.
Yes.
Why should I start?
Because it's your favorite. It was in your list. We are counting as 2023.
Okay. Nanpakal. It was actually I have a lot to say about this, so finally I can talk about Nanpakal. What I was saying before Nanpakal was Lijo Josh Parishari was going into kind of an RGV slump where he was because RGV listen I'm getting to
okay,
the
go
point.
For it
I was saying before Nanpakal was Lijo was getting into like an RGV phase where he was making these movies, he was making good movies, everybody was watching it, and you know, like I was like predicting that okay, he's gonna go into that slump, but then I think Nanpakal proved that entirely wrong, that he can take a very mature story and he can take a mature story and direct the hell out of it. I think that's what Nanpakal proved to me.
Even Churuli in a way was like on paper it isn't much that it's been like put out on screen, like it's directed.
Churuli feels
than...
very much like a director's movie also, I feel.
Churuli, I think I would say it's like I think it was an experiment.
Yeah,
I think Nanpakal is like the payoff to Churuli, where he
exactly that's what sense. I was gonna yeah. say. That. Yeah.
And Nanpakal definitely, I have to say it's very transfixing. The experience, you know, especially how it uses sound
camera.
Design,
camera
and sound
also,
design.
Also sound design both. Yeah,
sound design is ultimately is so good because you know it's set in this small village. It's like it's timeless, right? So all it's playing is like old Tamil songs and old like Tamil TV shows and serials and stuff like that. So the time, the way they use all the surrounding to make what happens on screen more believable, you know, just with sound design. Like you don't see these things, you just hear the songs and you instantly connect to to the feeling. To what he's trying to translate on screen. It also, I think it's a nice bridge between, because I think Malayalis and Tamil people have always had this thing with this connect. And I think this movie portrays that really well, where it bridges the gap between the Malayalis and the Tamil people. I think it's a great collaboration. But obviously, this is Mammootty the movie. I don't think before I can say that, there are other actors who are doing other things, right? Like I can say, but with Nanpakal, it's Mammootty the movie. It's made for him. He's shining in it because he's so effortless. Like
it's also very body oriented performance, right? Because it is always very physical. There's hardly a sort of close up,
which is this absolutely brilliant mirror scene where he's just
the red and green light thing. The inter
where he looks into the mirror.
The close up, the one where you get I think that's as much to do with the direction also, as much to do with the performance, of course. But
Definitely. But I thought the performance was more effortless was when he switched from James to Sundaram. Where he just, there's just this thing where he walks into the house. And he just starts, like, it's the language switch as well, right? Yeah. See, I'm not saying Namuni's Tamil is perfect. It's not, there's obviously pronunciation, these things where you can
But that works, it works with the film's theme also a little bit.
Definitely.
No, it's
definitely,
the bridge.
It does work.
It is actually, while when the film starts, he does thank that ad. Do you know about the ad?
Yes. I got to know about
Neither
this from my friends.
Yeah.
Please give context.
Yes.
So
there is this ad. I'm not sure which. There's this ad wherein there is a Punjabi boy. Mm-hmm. And he's traveling in a bus with his mother. And suddenly he sees this Tamil house and he just he starts speaking in Tamil. He says, stop the bus, and he gets down and he starts acting like a different person.
Mummy ko bolo na mujhe bahar nahi dekhna de rahi hai.
Are bachcha use chhod do bahar dekhne do.
Aap chup raho ji.
Bas nirsinga.
Huh?
Vandi nirsinga.
Are ye kaun si bhasha hai?
Oye maro. Kutta ruk ja.
Shin feed.
Oye kutta ruk ja.
Shin table.
Huh?
Heen table, Savitri, heen love, Sami.
Hey Sami.
Green plywood, janam janam ka saathi.
Savitri,
Sami,
Savitri, Sami.
I'm sure like the ad would be what, like a minute long or something? Or
less
2 minutes
that,
long,
probably.
Right?
Less than that.
No, so, I mean, of course, here, of course, it's like a you have to sustain that, right? And I think one of the, I told Sanjeet after coming out, it reminded me of Api Chitpong's Memoria, which is not a comparison I would expect to be reminded of when I was watching this. But it's a, I was so drawn by like, you know, short composition changes and just how much via those short compositions you're lulled into sort of going into the other zone or the other language.
I think it's
like the bridging
you're talking basically of like the short taking, which is very similar in a way, but I feel here what really held me more than Memoria was actually the character. There are these things which Lijo does very like, you know, eccentrically. He'll put the character in places, he'll put, and he does like a lot with sound, like not just now from his previous film.
No, that's true. That's very true. No, I mean,
which is very interesting. Although I don't understand the context or like a lot of nuances because I don't know the language.
Same.
But
so
it's not a language context thing. It's like it's not that you have to know the language. It's the thing is, it's more like world building. It's not entirely necessary.
No, today morning, I watched the Nanpakal review by Barzajarangar. And he pointed out so many references, and that's why it started feeling like, you know, I don't know this.
I don't think it's necessary.
Of like the 40s, 50s of Tamil cinema, where he's using like these songs which represent a certain religion or something, and foolishness and stuff like that, which I can't understand.
You get the essence of it though, I feel like, even though
I would want more information because Lijo does like a lot of pointing towards things, like he'll point towards like a cosmic connection, like a lot of
there
is this one point where the old grandma or the mother is watching the blind lady is watching television, and there are these flying saucers and all of that, which I feel he's kind of pointing towards so many things, but he never really.
Earlier also, Churuli is like out and out, like you're saying. I'm not getting the right word. There's this surreal, very, you could say a lot of absurdity in how these stories are, you know. So it could go anywhere. That is the problem. Yeah. So it's very risky if you take something like that. Even the way Nanpakal ended, I feel it only because it is Lijo, he could end it like that.
So pretty mm-hmm. glorious yeah. ending, I think, from whatever.
Yeah,
I
that is.
And this, there's also this thing, a common thing with Chorli is that yeah. when like they both cross a bridge and they change.
Yes, yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, yes, yes.
Exactly.
Yeah, yeah. In Chorli, when they cross the bridge, everybody starts getting rude. Everybody starts cussing. Yes.
Yeah. I mean, I still yeah. remember the way yeah. that scene is shot, the Chorli bridge yeah. scene. It reminds me of like Wages of Fear and like all
Wages
all
of older, and yeah, Sorcerer.
Sorcerer. Like it's just really yeah, yeah, yeah. the violence of
which
the
is, which, is what, which is what my initial point was, right? When I was like, when you see Lijo's previous films, he has a like what do I say, radical type of filmmaking.
Yes. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
There's almost radical. There's a brashness to it.
Yes. Mm-hmm, right? Mm-hmm.
It's not that. There's no like patience. Yes. Not in the way, not in like in the filmmaking sense. I'm saying there's no patience where like handheld shots, right?
Yeah.
You know, like people are running.
It's very chaotic. The way
yes.
he
yes. tells. Mm. Yes, chaotic. Yes, chaos. Right.
This is opposite.
Yeah, exactly. So mm-hmm. that, when I was saying he's going to an RGV slum, because I am watching old RGV movies right now. Yeah.
Sanjeet, your episode, do it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so that's why I was comparing it, where I was like, okay, they both of them started off making like movies with you know, like kind of offset from the what everybody was making yeah. at that time.
Yeah.
Brash, being very brash, the camera movements being very frenzy and stuff like that. But with Nanpakal, I say the maturity shows where he has this script and he has this great actor and he uses that so like mm-hmm. nicely, right?
Yeah,
like
yeah, yeah.
It's chaotic, but it's not the Angamali Diaries chaotic. It's it's chaotic in another sense. And it's also another thing I noticed was it's a theater troupe, right? So a lot of the shots are also staged like it's a stage. Like the camera is, there's a wide angle shot and they're all in the center. They're moving left and they're moving right.
Yeah.
Like
there's a life's where... a stage thing also, right? That they say in the film. I don't remember clearly, yeah, yeah, but there is something about stage.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like yeah. that whole philosophy of life is a stage and you are a performer.
No, no, no. That's a quote where life ends when you sleep. Sorry,
no, there's another one with the stage thing also, I think.
Okay, I don't think so. It's somewhere in the middle. I forgot, but there is something, yeah.
Yeah, so there's a shot where...
The quote, you are referring to that Thirukkural, right?
Thirukkural, yeah.
Yeah, that's actually somewhere in the beginning, very beginning itself.
Yeah, oh, yeah, the yeah. one.
No,
yeah,
I
yeah.
Yes,
yes. Where he's talking to the... Where he's talking
the
to the...
Hotel person at the place, right? Yeah. Hotel, yes. Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, so what I was saying was there's a shot, very wide shot. They're all on the road in the night. They're thinking where to sleep. And, you know, the bus is in the center. They're all in the center. And then they start moving left, right. They start moving like left, right. It's almost like a stage direction. The way they used, and they're all like the actors as well, like contrasted to the young non-actors that he uses. This one has like more experienced actors, right? Especially somebody like, there's this actor called Puram who passed away. The Puram is the father-in-law who doesn't say a lot in the movie.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So he was a very like respected actor who passed away before the movie came out. So, you know, like how it uses like veteran actors also. It doesn't just use newer, but so in that contrast, I'm saying like he's the maturity shows, and I fully trust him to do whatever he's doing next, because I finally know that he's not that type of filmmaker. Malaikutti Valiban, I have my thoughts on that, but we'll see.
Oh, already
predicting my first Lijo's air movie. That's my first prediction. Because Mohanlal is involved in it, I'm not that this thing. But yeah. Anyway.
So
yeah,
we'll move on because we have so many movies to cover. Otherwise, we will probably revisit Nanpakal sometime. Nanpakal. Huh? Sanjeet,
yeah,
you
yeah,
wanted to
sure.
do a full episode.
Yeah,
right?
yeah, yeah.
I think it's worth it also. So we can do Thallumalla first, Maheedhar, then we'll do Monica, because Monica is also in Sanjeet's list. So,
yeah.
Any thoughts on Thallumalla, which also I haven't
You haven't seen Thallumalla?
No, I've heard very Edgar Wright comparisons by some
people. Okay. So, yeah, there is that. I was going to ask you that. Do you like Edgar Wright?
I love Edgar Wright.
So then you will probably love you will love Thallumalla, because it's not just Edgar Wright. It's I think especially Malayalam movies, right? From what I've seen, even the commercial movies, so I think in Tamil films, commercial movies exist in two things. There's a social space and then there's the full-on commercial space. That I don't think that exists in Malayalam cinema that much, at least to an extent in other industries as well. So I think for the first time there's a Malayalam commercial movie that's like it owns what it is. It's not holding back anything, you know. It's not like disguising itself to be something else. It's marketing itself absolutely as what it is, and does everything what like it's advertised itself as. It's not it's not pretending to be deep. It's not pretending to be anything else. It's a movie about men fighting each other, and the fact that they have no redemption because men are animals who just have to fight. And that's just the basic part of the movie.
Also, and just how they find friendship through that fight, you know.
Yes, exactly. It's just for men, fighting is like the ultimate, like the last. Like they never go back. So that's the point of the movie, and it shows that, and it's just that, and plus that it's just a romp. It's just, you know, it's fun. And you know, I don't like saying like leave your brains at home kind of I don't like that concept of saying don't think while watching this movie, but I think Thallumalla is truly that movie where you don't have to think a lot, because there's so much happening that you will be kind of confused of what's happening by the time the next scene comes on.
Got it.
Yeah.
No, that sounds. I mean, I'm very interested, because I need to watch. I think I'm going through a phase where I need to watch films which don't require my head to be working. So.
No, you definitely don't. You will. Yeah, you just
color, fun, and fights and everything.
Just let it flow. Like, don't think about anything. That's the best way to go into the movie. Don't even watch the trailer. I would say that would make it even better.
Done. Okay. Mm-hmm. So Monica.
Okay.
Now.
Yeah.
Sanjeet, I mean, this is actually, we've discussed this, so Maheedhar, you chime in the most. We have actually covered this before.
Monica, I like Vasanthvada, and Monica was good. And that's what I mean. I didn't expect the sci-fi thing. I think that's the only thing that I don't like about the movie. They dragged out a little bit.
Okay, considering how
the sci-fi thing. What was the sci-fi? The
whole robotic section. I feel.
Yeah. Octopus. I think that. Yeah. Oh, actually. Oh my God. Now it is that. Saying, now I'm realizing.
It's just
that. Yeah, I'm realizing.
You didn't know.
No, it's hitting right now. That.
Okay.
Yeah. No, but no. I mean, Monica Vardalan was very fun. I don't know. Yeah. It's. I have nothing against Bollywood movies, but I find it very hard to enjoy. Don't worry.
We have had a stinker of. I mean, as someone who's, I mean, Sanjeet is better versed in saying or putting out his verdict on Bollywood, but I don't. It's been a rough year.
No, yeah.
That's putting it lightly. Also, that is.
Yeah, but I would have loved a theater release. Actually, I would have seen
trust me, even I said the same thing to Dhruv.
I think you have it in recording, Sanjeet.
Yes.
Would have definitely.
Yeah, because it's a perfect film to go to cinema and enjoy. Yeah. Just like legit, just like have fun type movie, which doesn't happen that often. Doesn't happen.
But also, a lot of the movies very Netflix overrated, were curated, which understandably like the story,
I mean, you have to. It's a push and pull game, right? How much you can pull towards yourself to, you know, make your film and just like compromise some. I think nobody makes a film without compromising some bits of their film.
Yeah, definitely. But I think that like the movie, I don't think this would have been the same movie in a theater. Like it would have been a lot different. That is what I'm saying.
It would have still been fun because I feel Vasanbala knows where his own bits lied. I feel
Marth, so. Marth worked so much.
Yeah, yeah. Even I enjoyed that. I mean, yeah, I even like his the short film Spotlight with.
You are the one sole fan of that. I feel.
Yeah, one sole fan of it.
That Ray one. The Ray one.
Yes.
I remember watching it, but is it the one with Radhika Madan in it?
Yes. And it's supposed to be the favorite.
Huh?
And Sanjeet's other favorite, Harshvardhan Kapoor,
my favorite. Oh, yeah. Yes.
Two poor can't buy Bugatti.
Who wants
problem is he did Bhavesh Joshi, so you can't really say anything now.
I mean, he did Bhavesh Joshi, which is a good
He champions good cinema, which I feel is more than enough at this point in Hindi cinema at this point.
He was also at AK versus AK. I'm just remembering that.
Like, he was good in AK versus AK.
He made Thar also. So.
Oh, AK versus AK was not a good film. But yeah, we'll move on from AK versus AK. Vanika, my darling, good, great film.
Devi, you also liked it, right? I think you had said.
It's not like on my top five or something, but still.
I really liked Radhika Apte.
I enjoyed it. Yeah. She was absolutely fabulous. Actually, I did read a few posts on Instagram saying that she requires a standalone movie because that character is so interesting. So
they will make it. Don't give them ideas. They will make it. It's a universe building thing. So
yeah, I think it's based on some novel or something.
Ha,
it's
based on a Japanese novel. Yeah, why cast? Is it the cast who is good? I don't know. I don't think so.
So, I haven't read the novel, but usually when, as earlier we were discussing, Mahadir was telling about Bheeshma Parvam, how it's not an entire adaptation, but still, as you said, it is a template, right, for gangster films. Godfather is a template.
Yeah.
So, while you are adapting things more so, it becomes difficult, right? So,
I
don't know how the novel is or how it, but it didn't feel like that.
Oh, yeah. Like it's a fully cinematic thing. This is,
it has been taken from some other world and put here. So, that feel was not at all there.
It's almost there's a Sriram Raghavan genre, which is also a borrowing of Coen brothers and like older noirish sort of crime thrillers.
So much of quirkiness
The Pune cinematic universe is coming apparently. Sriram Raghavan wasn't, but apparently Monica Rupert Darling wasn't shot in Pune, it was shot in Bombay, which is very sad.
That was a good connection.
One thing I absolutely loved is how he has a beautiful idea of what he is doing, of the world. If you're talking about world building or even the characters, he has a very which is very rare. All kinds of characters are there in this film.
Yeah.
There is a South Indian. I'm not sure. Radhika Apte's character is Naidu.
From Madhya Pradesh, right? I think.
She's
Marathi. Marathi. Yes. Okay.
And then there is Monica. So
she's very good, also, huh? Huma
Qureshi. She's not Naidu. Naidu is her subordinate.
She's also Naidu. By the way, Naidu is Telugu.
Yeah.
Naidu is Telugu, exactly.
That's right. So there is
Vijay Shanti Naidu. Okay.
You see, Bombay for what it is. Like, there's so much of amalgamation of all these cultures.
Yeah.
And and each culture has been given a separate identity through these characters. Yep. And for which you have to have a certain understanding and knowledge.
Yep.
Not only that. The main character is Marathi, which I think is, I don't think Bollywood represents Marathi people at all.
No.
Similarly, all this, so that understanding is there in him, I feel, Vasanbala. So that is what makes his world. So even with all the quirkiness and everything, there is a specific identity, like how he was telling about Thallumalla. It's a very quirky film. You go with the flow, but there is a proper understanding understanding of what you are doing or where you are placed. Not only the geography, the people, the culture. So that is very important. And that comes across beautifully in Monica. It's something I really noticed and I really enjoyed amidst all the fun and how the movie goes.
Did well, right?
On
Netflix. It was on Netflix.
It did well in terms of viewership numbers, I suppose.
Critically,
Netflix is all in the air, right? Like, we can never say
they don't give, right? Give it. Yeah, never mind.
Yeah.
Okay, so Devi, we'll move on to yours.
Okay, my list.
Your list, yes. And then we'll, but like, we have some commonalities, so we will chime in. Yes.
Okay, so I have discussed most of this in, actually, we had done another podcast with Pima Sitsinma, so I have discussed these films, not all these, but some of these films. So, Natchathiram is my favorite film of 2022. That's not because it's entirely like in all aspects or in every respect, it's perfect, not because of that, but first of all, it's Paranjit, and I am a huge fan of Paranjit. Whatever he tries to do, I try and follow. I mean, I try and watch whether he directs or produces. So most of whatever he has done, and even his interviews. So you know, there are these certain filmmakers who are really trying to bring about a change, right? In like how you were talking about Lijo. It's a very very different kind of filmmaking. So or different kind of different feel to what cinema is. So similarly, I mean, I really like what he's trying to do with cinema. Or through cinema, Paranjit. So, because of that, I watched this movie. And
I mean, and Sanjeet will button also because it's in our list. Yeah. So, Sanjeet, this is your favorite. You have recommended to me gazillions of times, and I listened to you again. So, yeah, what do you want to say?
I really enjoyed it. I mean, again, Paranjit also one of my favorites. Same as Devi, but
I just wanted to complete like
one sentence. Please go ahead.
Just that how the one thing that impressed me the most in this film is how he has brought in this, he has this idea of revolution that he brings in with every, there is this politics that he brings in every film of his. So he has done the same here with love.
He has brought that's in, the tagline, right? Love is politics. Love is political. I forgot.
So there's very, I don't know the taglines, but it's a very revolutionary way of dealing with love or understanding, defining love, even something that is not even definable, that kind of a love he's you know, telling. So that's one thing I absolutely loved in this movie.
To Devi, even I really enjoyed it. Like the whole revolutionizing thing is like a part of the whole process, I feel. But Paranjit, like always, I think I'm a bigger fan of his filmmaking than anything else, because how he uses a certain theme and then puts it in a story, because there is a story. It's not like it's not like a randomly put together, you know, moments or whatever.
Yeah,
it's a cohesive story. He gets in all these characters and always plays around with these characters. Even in Sarpatta, he did so well. I'm not so much of a big fan of Kala, but I feel there is like a lot of merit to what he did and how he did. There are these very specific things which kind of don't maybe make sense, but maybe when you are like writing it I feel there's like a lot of merit to it in a lot of ways. But Natchathiram, I think, is a lot of people didn't enjoy it but I did, because I feel he moved away from what he had been doing so until this point, and then he goes into more of an urban setting in a way, like his base shifts.
Contrasted
from like,
later with
it shifts from like thing, more localized, like, you know, communities to like to Pondicherry straight up. Not even like urban Chennai or whatever, but it's like more of like a complete shift to an Anglo Indian community or like a city.
I'm sorry, I'm just interrupting. I just wanted to I just wanted to point out one thing, but still the art that they are making is very much about their rural, you know, if you see the drama also,
it's
based on honor killings. That side of Paranjit, where you are, you know, speaking against a social evil or an issue, yeah. or you are raising a social issue.
I mean, it's very what you're saying is totally right. I mean, the idea of the political aspect is intertwined now with whatever mm-hmm. he is trying mm-hmm. to say. There is no sort of separation between the two. And this is my first foray into, I mean, this is my favorite also of whatever, and the second favorite, I suppose, but of whatever I have seen. And this is my first Paranjit film. So for me, it was very much again, introduction to his world. And Sanjeet had kind of mentioned this before about the 360 degree mm-hmm. view, right? Which is him and like Vetrimaran, I think.
Mari Selvaraj.
Okay. So again, that 360 thing is very hard to do, I think. Firstly, because I mean, I think I've seen a lot of films from last year which try to do it, but have not managed to collide all the worlds together in a way which feels cohesive and sort of, mm-hmm. you know, that they builds upon each other. And I think here, I mean, I think the best way to communicate a story also about a lot of people is to put them in one setting, and this kind of does that. It's a lot to do with the theater group, and I can see why people are put off by it because it's so upfront about its themes and all that. And I am generally also, but I thought this was really, really well done. I especially loved how the scenes in the theater group sort of, you know, contrast with the later scenes take place in someone's house, which are similarly performative. You know, they similarly very much going as a sort of society, like the social roles. Again, watch the social roles and performance and all that. But more than anything, it is a really, I thought it sort of whizzed by. It's a long movie, but it didn't feel that long to me.
50 minutes.
How it just ended, like that is my favorite part of the movie. Even with all the complexities, there is this hope that we can coexist, right?
Yes.
Even if nothing
only in
goes
movies right, though, Devi. That's the beauty of movies.
No, see, nothing goes according to plan. The drama, they couldn't do the drama, nothing goes well. But still we could, if we are just together, if we could just, even with all the complexities, all the incompatibilities, if we could still be together and still watch the stars for even for 2 seconds, it matters.
Cinema
is also like that, you know. It's just that one minute or that one second that you just, you know, take one step back and think, oh, am I doing right?
Yeah.
So that is what art should do somewhere. Yeah. It should.
I actually have a point related to that.
Yes.
To what you just said. So I have two things to say. First, I'll talk about this. I have a friend, my classmate. Mm-hmm. So he is I don't want to I don't want to insult him. He's just a normal man, right? You know, his perceptions of a straight Indian male.
Yes.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I don't know how else to put it.
No, it's so funny. It's probably the correct way to put it also.
Yeah. Just a straight Indian male. Yeah. In our colleges, we are learning about a lot of things, right? In our college, in our classes, they're making an effort to have more inclusivity, to learn, make more things about feminism. And everyone in our class, obviously, a lot of the guys grumble about it. Hopefully no one listens to this. But anyways, we have to share it with them. No, that's never going to happen. So we went for Natchathiram. Me and this friend went for Natchathiram the first day. Yeah. And this was at a time when he was also talking a lot about this. He started talking more about, he would sit and he would be like, okay, this is what she's trying to talk about. I can understand what she's saying.
Mm-hmm.
And after we watched Natchathiram, we stepped out and I think for just like half an hour, we just had a conversation about this.
Mm-hmm.
And I think it's very nice to see like what she said, you know, when art reflects that. I think it was nice to see him at least having a conversation about it.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's talking about how members of LGBTQ should, how they are living. He was also having a conversation. I think that one thing, which is good, right? Because it changes people. Art is changing people.
Yep.
And the second thing is the response to the movie, which it was trolled a lot and everything. Primarily, all the parodies movies before this, mostly they had dealt with identity politics. That's the most they could go with, like the most he could get away with, because he couldn't, like this Natchathiram, I think he had no restraint. So he just went bombastic with it. He sent whatever he had to. And you might not like what I'm saying, but there is a beauty in when you are restrained and you're trying to say something. The backlash for it is, like, I can see why, because in like movies like I will say Kabali and Sarpatta, like the identity politics is playing a lot, big role, because in Kabali the main theme is in most part of the movies the main theme is they are wearing better clothes, if you wear better clothes they will respect them like one of us. That's like the main core of Kabali, where it's like, okay, you know, like it's about how you live, it's not about where you live, it's about how you live, if you live good, right? So, and same, like, you take something like Karnan, which kind of exploded on this, like, identity politics front, right? Yeah. Where it's a movie where they're literally breaking the restraint, right? There's no more control this thing, you know, like, they're fighting back, right? Yeah. So, I think, but Karnan has a more commercialized filmmaking way, and the message is more commercialized.
Template is there, no? I think a little bit. It's still centered on Dhanush, right? I think that was the...
But in that, at least they're fighting back. There's no restraint. The restraint is thrown away. So, I think Natchathiram went the same way, but it's not... Again, it has a lot to unpack, and there's a lot being said. That's why the backlash is...
is understandable, I think, but it's again, like, it's the whole thing, right? Like, if you either you can operate within genre and or template and make a change, or you can do this and sort of, you know, explode through it almost. And if you explode through it, it's going to have a backlash regardless. And I mean, I can understand it. It has.
I think that's what I'm saying, right? Yeah. When a filmmaker has restraint.
Yes.
Like, he had a restraint, but he showed it in a way that came across to everybody without it being not condescending. How do you say more like, there's a lot of information in Natchathiram, which compared to his other movies. So I think that's where the backlash is obvious. The interesting thing will be to see the response to this in maybe like 2 to 3 years.
These will last. I mean, there's another film that didn't work for me as much, and I don't know, we are not going to include it, and I know we have so many films to go through that I just want to mention it, but Jhun didn't work for me as much, right? But the way it plays
Amitabh
around
Bachchan movie, right?
But the legacy it will have will be 100% there, I think. Like, I know the film didn't work for me. It's working. It's essentially taking a sports drama template and playing around with it in a way where it completely almost inverts it. Not inverts it, but like changes the priorities, the way it tells a story, I think. So, like, again,
I would actually put Nagra and Manjule with Mahari Selvaraj. Both of them are very open about it. They are not at all subtle. Because even the lyrics of the songs are so, like, unsubtle about it. What I was saying was the lyrics are not that subtle. So, I mean, I would say what you're saying about Jund, I think that's a different thing, because Jund there's a lot more things except the identity politics as well. There's a romance and everything.
Yes. This is hidden, like Natchathiram is like directly going for it. There's no sort of indirect barrier about it.
Yeah, there is no restraint. Paran is just going crazy with whatever he has.
That's an approach which will automatically always have divisive opinions, I feel. Having divisive opinions is not a bad thing. The trolling is, I feel, always unnecessary, but whatever, it will happen regardless. So you can't do anything.
It is not his actual, as you said, add on to what he said. It is not his usual, even though it is his signature style, it is not that when you are talking about love and when you are talking about even that theater space, it is a very free thinking space.
Yes, that's the space that he's created, I think.
Yes, exactly. So there are these like endless discussions, endless disagreements. So we are just being taken into that, and you're following that. And
if you want to follow it,
no, in the sense you are listening to it, you are just you are also in a way partaking, participating, being a silent listener, even spectator, even. So that is the difference, I think, with respect to how his other films have been. And that is, as he said, since it is covering a lot of things, there's no boundaries.
Yes,
that's what he was telling, I guess, about the restraints and so that is how we were discussing about how the growth of sensibilities can be good and bad for you know a film viewer. So it's the same way, without a restraint, without any boundaries, it can go into two different spaces. It is it is equally
I feel it's not a bad thing to like it making divisive opinions and reactions is totally fine. I mean, again, you do the divisive thing in a productive way. Of course, the trolling, trolling productive? I don't know. Maybe it is.
At least it's opening a conversation.
Love pathi or nadagam pannalam. Contemporary love. Indha kaalathu kadhal kadhaiya.
Thali kattina mattum dhaan namma love continue aavuna.
உணர்த்தினீக்கிரமா
Okay, Devi, move on. There's a lot of things to cover. Yes.
Yeah, this one is also actually, I don't know if I can call it the second best. This is equally good, Aavasavyuham. It is unlike anything I have seen before. So for the sheer idea here, it fascinates me in every way. And how they turned it, that's what I did write about it also on my Instagram, and how this could have taken a very different turn also, like how this could have taken the shape of water way, like how this could be the love story between, you know, but it didn't. And it went into a very different zone, which I wasn't expecting at all. And this whole talk about nature, and recently, I think a day or so before, there was an interview where Anurag Kashyap was telling how we don't pay much attention to documentaries. They get represented in Oscars, how many of us view it, how many of us know about it or see it. So this is actually a very good way of approaching.
It's a hybrid, right? Mockumentary, is it even a mockumentary, it is not exactly there,
but there is documentary.
The format is there, like the people talking to the camera, right? Like talking heads, basically. Yes.
Yeah, so that is there. So again, it is a very thought-provoking way, and it's very, I think it's more than watching a documentary, which could feel dry, or which could feel okay, which
I will flag up. I will stick up for documentaries, considering
this is a way to open this up to more people. I'm giving a more simple example, like how another film in my list, Badai Do, why I like the film is it is making something a different kind of an idea of a family or a marriage to a more mainstream audience. It's making it mainstream. And it is not like how even people talk about pink. It's not. It's because that idea has become more, it has, it's not just, there's no strict division of art house and mainstream in such films. So it serves as a bridge, as you know, mm-hmm. someone was telling earlier. So similarly, this is a bridge, and it's a beautiful bridge. And it's, you know, talking about nature and how it can, how interconnected all this, and how sometimes so conflicting it is.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, obviously,
how,
we were my word.
Understanding. What it entirely is, and whatever we don't understand, we fear, and we try to kill at the first instance of, you know, trouble. So all that, you know, very, very thought provoking.
No, obviously, what I think is the bigger, I mean, not the bigger, but I was about to say it's the more quote unquote experimental approach to this compared to something like Badhaido. I think Badhaido is still very much operating in. It's doing more things
but
within
because it is just concentrating on one issue and one thing.
Yes.
This is a little bit more vast because it takes on ethical, social, ideological,
environmental,
political, environmental, philosophical aspects. So this is such a huge thing.
Yeah,
so it's much more experimental in that sense. So I just wanted to put that point across of, you know, putting it into the mainstream. So
did it do well in the cinema?
OTT, Sony Live.
OTT, okay, it was OTT, yes.
Sony Live.
And by the and the director also has a new movie coming, which I'm excited for.
Yeah.
It's called Prema Purushan. I forgot the title, but anyways, what she said was, she said it was the most unique. It's one of the most, like, unique movies I've seen, like, in recent years. So fresh, like, there's nothing like it. You can't, like, and, like, in every movie, you are like, okay, this is... inspiring of something. This movie, I can't pinpoint what it inspired. It's just so like nothing I've ever seen, especially the filmmaking style.
Yes.
It's so new. It's very like, what do you say? It's just, it feels like a documentary only, the way the filmmaking is, but it's still, everything feels so like good. Like all the dialogues are so well.
They don't feel
natural or stale. The filmmaking is also
very dynamic.
And plus what they're trying to say, about the ecosystem, not only the natural ecosystem, but also the human ecosystem, where, you know, how everything comes around like to a circle, right? Like everybody wants to make money, everybody wants to profit off something. We pretend like we care about something, but in the end, we just want the profit of it. We don't really care.
And we care only about ourselves.
Yeah, exactly. Right. The man.
That should be the ending of our episode, not the midpoint. Yes.
So, but there's one thing I wanted to mention. Like now, when he said something. This year, 2022, whatever films that I have been through, most of the films on my top 5 list are also. If you see, it's a mix of myth and realism, and Aavasavyuham to a certain extent does that, and even a movie like Kantara. Or
this is, you know, Devi, this is like being expert at rattling through your list in a quick time. You've gone through Badhaido also, and now Kantara also you mentioned. So you only have got to get left. Go ahead.
Just because all these somewhere is so interconnected. I'm just thinking about the year, how it has been for, you know, it's a beautiful mix of films. You have, as I said, you have Kantara, Mahavir, and there is one movie called Kumari. It didn't do well, but
that is again
about myths and fables and all. And then you, on the other side, if you are taking Malayalam cinema, because I have watched Malayalam most, so there is a very realistic touch of films like Puru, or say Nanta Case Kuda, or Pada, Joe and Joe. So films like that are also there on the other side. So that is that's a beautiful, you know, mix. I'm just talking about 2022.
Next Instagram post, this is right. encapsulation of your own.
So it feels like, you know, more importance is being given to storytelling more than anything.
Yeah.
So all kinds of genre, all kinds of films have, frankly, it has worked to be, if the story is, you know, amazing.
Because we are short of time, expand on Gargi, which
Gargi
Sanjeet
again,
has also seen, right?
It was again a very a huge surprise package for me, actually. I watched it very late, and it really, the more than anything, how the story moves and everything, I was very touched by the performance, by Sai Pallavi's performance.
Mm-hmm.
Absolutely. Fantastic. Oh, she was amazing. Mm-hmm. And how it requires a certain restraint, but at the same time there is a lot of emotions that you know go through her, and it's very hard to, I believe it's very hard to perform something like that. Mm-hmm. Which with equal restraint as well as, you know, and emotions, and making it feel so personal. Mm. And how it ended, you have all seen the film,
I have not,
right?
Seen it. Maheedhar, have you seen it?
No, I haven't seen that.
So don't it's spoil the ending, please. Devi. We so will.
Okay,
we will.
So we won't be talking about it. So yeah.
Yeah.
So again, it was a surprise package.
Got it.
In terms of, as I said, the storytelling was amazing.
Okay. Oh, great, Sanjeet. You only have one movie to add, because all of the other ones have been covered.
All of the other ones are one.
Rave karo.
I mean, Thiruchitrambalam, I really, really enjoyed. So it's like, I think I really, now I've started enjoying like a lot of simple stuff done well. Like I really don't want like, just like excessive things for the sake of a type cinema anymore.
Example?
I mean, not anymore. I mean, at the moment I feel. Examples I'll give you personally, don't worry. I'm talking about... Okay. Thiruchitrambalam, which is, I think, like a lot of simple emotions which require only certain set of, you know, things that need to be done in a certain way to extract that emotion out, right? I mean, it's a very conventional story in a way. It's like a guy who does like a lot of delivery jobs and aspires to have like a lot of money, but he has strained relation with his father and talks about that one mistake which basically changed his life and a lot of other things. But at core, the film is driven by just basic emotions.
Hmm.
And that for me is like the big winner in a lot of ways, because and I think maybe at this point, like I really wanted to watch, I mean, I wanted to watch Lal Singh Chadda in theater in August, but I couldn't because like I was working and I missed out on it. And at that point, like, I think it hadn't come out even on OTT or something like that. But then Thiruchitrambalam had come out fairly earlier than that on Sunnext or something. And I watched it and it gave me exactly what I wanted. I wanted to laugh. I wanted to enjoy. I wanted to cry. It just gave me basically the whole package of what I wanted from like that kind of... Like, I wanted to watch that Aamir Khan movie for those kind of emotions.
Mm.
And Thiruchitrambalam became that kind of for me. And I think I've seen it like some... 4 times already this year, because every time I see it, it's the same reaction, it's the same kind of fun that I have with the film, which doesn't really happen that often anymore. Like even though I love like stuff like Everything Everywhere All at Once.
I mean, the other film you've rewatched like a maniac is Decision to Leave. All you want is
Decision
laughter and tears, right? That's it.
I want
I mean,
complete
that's
package.
What he said about Thiruchitrambalam is actually very, very true. You know,
it's
very hard to make simplicity work like this.
Yeah.
And
a simple story, it's as you said, basic emotions. But then again, I particularly love that how the relationship between the father and the son, you know, the transition and how genuine it is, how real it is, and how relatable it is to us at next time. Mm-hmm. So,
they put in effort, like in on every bit of detail when his I'll just reveal like one detail, which is like where his father has paralysis and he's kind of falling and he doesn't help him. And that's
I have written about this exact scene. I've just picked this scene. I've written about it in a post because that is my favorite. That was that small action, as you said. That is exactly how it would be. And they had placed it as it is. Yeah, correct. Yeah.
And then there's also like parallelly his life, his love life and stuff like that, which is, I feel like, how we go through his life basically becomes our kind of, like, you basically invest in his life in the character's life, which doesn't happen that often. So I mean, I really had like a very good time No, it's great. That is why I would.
It was a surprise for everybody because it crossed 100 crores in the box office. It's not a high stakes film, or nor mm-hmm. is it marketed as a heavily dramatic film.
No, exactly.
It's still everybody watched that film.
Same
lovely
thing.
I didn't expect
anything of the film because I was like, what? And I had seen what is that other Dhanush film that he did this year, Maran, which was horrible. and I was like, okay, I don't know what to expect from this film either. But this film, I was like took me to another level. So I was like, okay, this works so well. And doing like the bare minimum, not the bare minimum, just like getting you.
No, like basics.
Cinematic
right?
space.
Basics.
Yeah. I mean, basics and done so well. So basics, and also like a bad.
Basics done specifically, in fact. I'm guessing it's got specificity.
You're correct. Yeah. Also, banger soundtrack by Anirudh. So,
no, please. Another... The soundtrack is all over. I'm tired of hearing it at this point.
I'm not tired of it. That's what I say. I still listen to it every day.
Kannaliye sonnadi vaarthai illa.
Kannaliye va. Adhe epdi?
Okay, Sanjeet, do you want to just go through your list? I mean, we've already discussed the others.
My list was Natchathiram, Nagargirathu, Thiruchitrambalam, Bheeshma Parvam, Vikram and Monica, my darling, which all of them have been discussed.
Yeah.
You can go ahead with your list now.
Wow, you switched. Nice switching of whatever moderation.
Yeah, I know. My transitions have become better with every episode.
I mean, it's good. Two of mine have been already discussed. So Aavasavyuham Devi had discussed, and then the other one was Natchathiram also.
Those two are
done. I'll rattle through Jalsa because I honestly... Yeah. So Jalsa is a pretty good movie that I would not think would be part of my year-end list in any other year other than this year or like last year maybe.
Because you haven't seen.
Both because I haven't seen and because... I mean, yeah, you said Lal Singh Chaddha is very good, but I've been trying to avoid that movie for the past like 5 years.
I liked
so, it. No, you know my reasons for avoiding it. So
yeah, I know.
So Jalsa is a solid movie. I think it's a very, I thought it's one of those slightly complicated thrillers that I generally gravitate to. And it's got like a couple of really solid performances.
Very solid, yeah.
I mean, maybe that's the reason I actually have it. I've been starved of seeing a good Vidya Balan film, and seeing her good in a good film is a bit of a thing, like a great thing for me, because I love her as an actor. We've discussed this Jalsa also, so I don't want to like extensively go into it, but if anyone's into like maternal melodrama, then yes, go for it. Then the other one is Kuttavum Shikshayam, which is recommended by you and Devi to me, so you guys can also please chime in. But this is my first. Rajiv Ravi is the director's name, right?
Yeah.
First film. So I was super impressed. Just because, firstly, I didn't know how to sort of... The story is fairly... Like, if you list it, it's very much like a normal... People go and investigate stuff, basically. Like, there's something that's happening and... Like a very crime genre template thing, right?
Yeah.
It's, again, about the filmmaking, I feel. Like, how it's sort of differentiated from the others. Type of
Rajiv Ravi is just one of those best. I think along with Amal Neerad, Rajiv Ravi is one of those filmmakers where you can't really talk much about their films. It's just like you watch it and you understand why they are good filmmakers, because they understand. Devi was talking about before at the word film grammar.
Yes,
right? Like the film grammar is like the way they use it is proper. You know they know what they're doing. Right. And Kuttavum, especially the way the police procedural happens and the way the shots are framed and the characters move, Right. Yep. Like so the comparison for most of this was a movie called Thiran Adhikaram Ondru.
Thiran, yeah.
So Thiran Adhikaram Ondru almost follows almost pretty much this exact same this thing.
Yeah.
When
yeah.
there's a series of robberies in Tamil Nadu, in Thiran at least. And
the
police officers go to Rajasthan to investigate it. And it's the same in Kuttavum Shikshayam where there's robberies in Kerala and the police go to the state to this thing. But that you see like how different the treatment is, because in Kuttavum Shikshayam it's treated more like the police are humanized, you know.
They almost felt lost to me sometimes.
Humanized it, like I am, you know, ACAB and all, leave that aside. It's just that you know, like you also see that, you know, these are human beings with struggles, right? They're not doing they are not evil because you know, like, you know how you say there's a rotten basket, rotten apple in every basket, right? They are not the rotten apples. They are just people who are trying to do their job. If you like Shikshayam, I would say watch Unda by which is also directed by the director of
Thallumalla.
Raman. Watch that, because I think it's fits in the same this thing of talking about police policemen, like, you know, everyday policemen. Which is all, that's a great film. But yeah, anyway, Kuttavum Shikshayam, I think it's just the film grammar.
First of all, it is actually this story. Why it is so, like, it's so you have that procedural aspect of it, the human aspect of it. Everything fits because it is inspired by an incident. That writer is a SI. Police SI. So it is from his life. Actually, I think if I'm not wrong, I've watched it long, but the character is also named Sibi. Asif Ali's character is also named after him, Sibi.
His name is something else, I think. Some sergeant or something, if I'm not wrong.
I will check.
I
will check.
So that is one thing I wanted to say, and another thing, as he was saying about Tamil Nirath, so basically as the cinematic grammar that you are referring to is absolutely correct. But if Amal Nirath is on one end of the spectrum, Rajiv Ravi is in the other end.
Total de-dramatization.
No, but I would say that this is like Kuttavum Shikshayam is probably the most different Rajiv Ravi film. I would say Kamati Padam is the most different because that film.
Stylistically, very, you know, there's this.
More somber.
It's also taking its time. It's not going
anywhere.
Which is also going with the theme of the film, right? Where everything is taking so long.
It is a slow burner.
Everything is taking so long. Like, they are going to the station. The policeman is like, come back again. So they go back and they do their work. You see all of that, right? Which makes us relate to them more. Like, they are watching TikToks and they are washing their clothes. Like, they're like all of us. They're just normal people.
Yeah, the procedure in the procedural, basically. It's all about that, right?
The procedural is not dramatic. Yes. It's not dramatic. It's just very normal.
Yeah. The one of the tensest sequences, actually, I've seen is the one where they go to the village, right? And they're just walking in the village, and then you basically have no idea what's going to happen. It's basically
like a maze only.
It's a horror film, basically. At that point, it changes into like a really slow burn sort of horror film where they're going through this village
Somewhere it reminds me suddenly. I'm sorry. Suddenly it reminded me of how in Nanpakal, like how everyone is searching for him. It's a similar situation where you are in an unfamiliar territory, right? So everything feels like a maze. Everything feels like a replica of the other things.
They feel a bit lost, right? The police officers always felt like they are sort of one or two steps behind everything that's going on.
They were figuring out all the time. Also figure out with them, right?
Which is what makes the Thiran comparison so much more interesting, because Thiran exactly plays out the same way where Kuttavum Shikshayam plays. For some reason, there is also a sequence in a village in Thiran Adhikaram Ondru where the policemen are looking for the criminals. They can't find them. It's the exact same way, but both of them are cop dramas. Both of them are about procedurals, about policemen chasing these criminals. But you see the
the treatment is so radically different,
completely
from where Thiran chooses to dramatize the action
and the romance action, and all of that.
Yeah, also, the action grammar is more. Yeah, the romance is more prevalent. When in this movie, the characters are given more prevalence. The
everything. I'm very excited to see. This is I told Sanjeev that this is the movie that Thar was trying to be. Maybe.
Yeah.
Right, I messaged you saying this. I think. But I don't remember now. Anyways, it's a bad comparison, to be honest, because...
You're referring to that Kate Winslet?
No. Okay. Thar is the...
The Harshvardhan Kapoor.
Harshvardhan and... Kapoor, Anil Kapoor movie this year. Yes. Kate Winslet.
Yes.
Where did Kate Winslet come?
Somebody.
Oh, Tar. Oh, you thought Tar, the Kate Blanchett
film. That's what I was thinking.
Okay. somebody told me that Tar was what the director saw No Country for Old Men, and he tried to make that. And
You already spoken about. Yes. In another lost episode.
But okay, anyways. Okay. My final film, it's probably my favorite. I don't know if we are counting it as an Indian film or should we count it as like an international? It's a combined production. No, because India, no one will produce a film like this right now. It's Payal Kapadia's A Night of Knowing Nothing. So this is another, actually, it's interesting that you said about how you're experimenting with forms. So this is like a docu-fiction also. Basically, like a poetic documentary, almost. It's basically this college student who finds letters. I won't spoil it much because I know none of you have seen it. There's nothing to spoil as such in terms of narrative. But it's very much about this person finding letters of someone who wrote to their ex-lover. And they're describing them what happened in their relationship and how they sort of separated because of certain reasons. And this sort of very gently dovetails into the political situation in India and how that's kind of linked. The whole personal political thing gets merged together. And I mean, again, it's one of those... It's great to see filmmaking like this. I know it's not... I discussed this with someone who was like, do you think there's like a purpose to this type of art house film? Because it is a very art house film. It's not a, it's not something that
it's
you
black
can.
Black and white also, right?
It's black and white, but that's the least of its art house things. I feel like it's
okay.
Heavily relies on voiceover. The visuals are always not entirely what the what is being said. So it's like it's got its inspirations in other like, you know, European art house cinemas almost.
Mm-hmm.
So I was discussing it with someone and they were like, do you think there's merit to you know, making these films because they only play to us cinephiles. Like they like their inspirations are very heavily art housey. So they won't like really play in the mainstream, which I think something like, you know, Natchathiram has above, like I would value Natchathiram's and other films is sort of, you know, ability to combine this into a mainstream template to make radical change. But like A Night of Knowing Nothing is one of those, like I watched it, it's a very like a gentle nightmare, if that's a way to put it. Like it really captures uncertainty in a way which I thought was really terrific. Like it's fully atmospheric. I feel that sort of cinema really works for me, at least. And the way you just go through someone's personal life and then dovetail into the politics, I think was one of the most smooth transitions, I think, which I think a lot of films this year, I thought struggled with integrating the personal political sometimes. So, I thought that was a really remarkable, and it's a first film. So I think it's... I mean, it's quite remarkable, I think. But again, I can see arguments being made against it in a similar mold to something like Natchathiram, in the sense that it has a film student almost quality to it, like a film, you know.
But certain themes, certain stories, you literally feel like this is the best way to tell it.
I mean, this really worked for me. But then I also know that this type of cinema works for me in general.
So... No, I understand the argument because I had a similar argument. There was this short film. It was called Disco Abu. I don't know if you have seen Disco Abu.
Mm-hmm.
It was... So, I mean, the argument about that film was how it's explored, how filmmakers or people in, exploit the poor. Mm-hmm. It was about this guy who was making a documentary about a poor, about a poor person.
Yes.
And I watched Disco Abu and my similar this thing was... We are watching this movie, like we are talking about it, but like we are only recycling the same thing. Like we are not, we can keep talking about, okay, how we are exploiting the poor people. But where does the cycle stop? Where does the conversation start? I had a similar discussion where the type of films that are reaching us, because not to go on a complete tangent, but Jafar Panahi is nowhere. Mm-hmm. This is the same thing, right? Where it's talking about, there are the people who are supposed to watch it aren't watching it.
Yes.
The people, like every there are people watching it, but the people who it's supposed to go to, right? Yeah. Like, I think Payal Kabadi, I don't think this documentary would play well in a gentle audience.
It won't play. Like, people will sleep or leave. So, yes.
No, not only that, right? Like, I'm saying political aspect.
It won't get released only. So, yes. Yeah.
But the point is, see, you watch something like this. You are a filmmaker, you watch something like this, you get inspired by this and you make something
that's more commercial.
That can happen. But certain stories, certain ways, I would say
that it's one of those films which has a conscience of itself. Like it's it interrogates itself also, and it's also interrogating this political situation. Like it's really well thought out. What Maheedhar is saying, I always struggle with also, because I'm like, this has always been my sort of, whenever I watch like super experimental cinema, I'm like, and like what, three people will watch it and what will happen, right? Kind of like that.
Something that we are drawn to.
I think it's the Indian struggle, right? I don't think like Western audiences have a problem, because they grow up on one type of, like Westerners grow up with a staple diet of media that they have. But but we Indians, I think we watch so much, like we watch English movies, we watch we watch our regional movies, we watch the other state regional movies, and you know, we are influenced by so much media. I think that I think this is a purely Indian like problem.
It's a good struggle to have. I mean, it's good. Like, I mean, I'm happy to have I think the films we've discussed today have been like the variety has been like insane in terms of just the types of style and all that we've kind of covered. So, I mean, I will at least probably try and do an episode on Night of Knowing Nothing also, because I think there's just a lot to talk about it.
Where is it available?
It's on Criterion channel, but it is also... You know where?
On illegals.
So it's never coming on Mubi and stuff. It's
surprising how it's not on Mubi. It seems like a very Mubi movie.
True.
I think that's it. We won't stretch it more, because we've already discussed a lot. Yeah. I think. Yeah. But good episode, Sanjeet. I think.
We discussed like.
We went through a lot, and we went through it. Yeah.
A lot of digression also, but it's fine, I think.
No, I don't think that much, but okay, whatever. I'm the one who's editing, so I will inform you how many digressions.
Magical, sir, magical. Great move.
Unless you want to edit, Sanjeet, I can send it.
I have some work to do.
Of course, yes. I'll edit.
I don't want to take another risk with Maheedhar episode.
So. I'll edit it.
Okay. I think this is the end of the episode. Thank you so much for listening. You can follow Dhruv on his Instagram page at Terminal Cinema. You can follow Devi and film.trans. You can follow Maheedhar. Maheedhar, do you want people to follow on Instagram?
I don't do anything useful, so...
You can follow him on Letterboxd. I'll link your Letterboxd.
Okay, thank you.
And then people can follow me on pixel_baba. Thank you so much for listening. Please share it with friends who would like to listen about films. And rate us on Spotify. And follow us on Spotify so that it reaches out to more people. Thank you so much for listening. This is the end of the episode. Khatam.
Babu, tum kaise ho? Tumhe hi sochti rehti hu. Har guzarte din thoda zyada. Main theek hu. Par ye sab jo ho raha hai, kuch samajh nahi aa raha.